Internet, good morning. My name is Magnitude, and today I have a Wi-Fi battle against Gubstacular for March Magnus coming your way. Now, his team, Roserade, Noivern, Magmortar, Tyrantrum, Empoleon, and Galvantula, and my team, Mega Manectric, Landorus-Therian, Gorgeist, Florgust, Azumarill, and Chandelure. Now, if you enjoyed the video, please leave a like, hit that like button. I'm shooting for 400 likes on my Wi-Fi videos and battles, and I'm hoping I can hit that goal. So that'd be fantastic if you do that. And, now, I thought he was going to lead with his Roserade, so or his Galvantula, trying to get Sticky Web up, so I decided I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to lead with my my Mega Manectric, because my Mega Manectric can handle his Roserade, can handle his Galvantula, and it can handle his Empoleon, as long as I'm not switching into like an offensive Empoleon. But I don't think, based on his team structure, it doesn't look like it's offensive. Doesn't look like he has a lot of defense in any way, so I figured anything that's got to be defensive. So he is going to lead with his Galvantula, but I am going to go ahead and lead with Mega Manectric, so I know he's probably not going to want to get a Sticky Web up. He's probably just going to want to attack me. So I'm going to become Mega, go for a little Flamethrower, take his little Bug Buzz, and we're going to go and see what happens from there. Then to that huge Intimidate. He has a lot of special attackers, so Intimidate. He has one physical attacker, so Intimidate not going to do much. That Flamethrower is going to bring him down to a Sash, and now I am going to outspeed him because of the fact that I become Mega, and he's got to switch out. He's going to go into his Tyrantrum, so I just go ahead and switch moves, and the off chance he goes into anything else in Thunderbolt. That is almost half. That is ridiculous. I really thought he was going to Earthquake me here. I really did. So I go into Chandelure with the Air Balloon. He does not have the Earthquake. He goes for a Dragon Claw, and it leaves me at 54. Now I can outspeed him, which is nice. So I'm just going to go ahead and just attack him. He goes into his Noivern, and I Shadow Ball. His Noivern going to do solid amount of damage, and I'm putting solid dents in his team. Like, half of his things about has under half HP. Going to Florgust, another predicted fairy move. He predicts that, goes for a Hurricane. That still doesn't do that much. He has Life Orb. Noivern is not long for this world. Now, I took Toxic off just before the battle. This had Toxic Protect, Wish Aromatherapy, and I thought that was really douchey. So I just put on Dazzling Gleam instead of, I got to put Moonblast on this thing. So that's why I don't have Moonblast, but Roserade can stop both a Toxic and a Fairy move, so Roserade a hard counter right off Florgust. I gotta switch out. I don't want to take a Poison move, so it's going to Gorgeist, thinking also he might put me to sleep. He does not put me to sleep, but he does get the Poison, which is huge, because that's going to nullify my leftovers and make it so I die, but I have nothing else really to take a Poison hit. I don't want Azumarill. Azumarill is neutral to it, so I gotta let Gorgeist die, unfortunately. He's not gonna do much at all this battle, but here you go, he just fades away on the layout there, but he's gone. A little upset about that, but that happens, I guess. Going to Manectric, I know, I really thought that he was gonna switch out into Empoleon here. So I go for a Thunderbolt. He does not switch out into Empoleon, there's nothing! And he goes for a Sludge Bomb, and that's the downfall now of Mega Manectric. So I just lost two guys in two turns, it's awful. And his Roserade now is, I'm afraid of it, because as long as his Noivern's still around, I can't just go for Earthquake. I really thought he was going to try and predict my prediction and stay in, but he just goes into Galvantula to scout to see what I'm gonna lock myself into. U-turn would have been the better play there by far, but I don't go for that, which is really unfortunate. I have to switch out now. He goes into Noivern, and I'm gonna go into Florgust, and he's gonna double switch on me and go into Roserade. Oh my god, what the good plays, man. The good plays everywhere. So I don't mind being in this spot, and I can probably stall him out, but he just goes to sleep powder and misses, and I just go for a wish, try to pass a wish to my Chandelure. Now I really thought that my Chandelure could take either one of these moves, a Leaf Storm or a Sludge Bomb. I thought more so he's going for the Leaf Storm, so I thought I could take that, but it turns out I don't, so that was a waste. Now, that does not mean I have wasted the Chandelure, which means that I'm down 5-3, so whatever. Going to Landorus, and he's going to switch out and go in back into his Toothless, and I thought that, we did it again, like I thought he was going to. Usually when we play like the second time, he does the opposite of the first time, turns out he did the same thing anyway, and he just goes double switches back into fucking Roserade again, so like, Jesus Christ, Gubs, this is ridiculous. Or double switches into Magmortar this time. But he just keeps double switching everywhere, but I know, I thought he was going to U-turn this time. He goes for Will-O-Wisp, thought I was going to go into anything else, but I don't have to, because I can just tank the thing all day. especially because he has no recovery after seeing that. So he's got to be either, he's got to be life orb at this point, or maybe a salt vest. He can't be a salt vest, he will. He's got to be like a life orb or something. He has no, maybe he's a berry, but he has no real recovery. So he goes for fire blast. I take that well. And I just go for Dazzling Gleam to put more damage on him. Now, I know I could live at least one more, and I really thought I was going to live at enough as to where Burn wouldn't take me out. I thought that was going to be the case. It was going to be really, really close. So he goes for a Fire Blast. I go for a Wish, which is going to be fantastic. I'm going to be able to get a Wish off, and I really thought after Lefty, I was going to be able to live after the Burn, but it turns out it does just enough where it takes me out. It sucks. I'm down like 5-2. How am I going to come back from this? So I go into Landorus-Therian, get the Intimidate to force a switch, and as long as that... I thought he was going to switch out into Toothless again, but he is not. I thought... So I go into Azumarill, luckily on the Fire Blast. He's going to Fire Blast me and not Will-O-Wisp me. If he Will-O-Wisp me, that would have been a good game, but I actually get the Wish back. He dies, which is cool. I get the Wish back, which is amazing, from the floor. This wasn't a wasted Wish. I'm only down 4-2. I got this. I thought... Now, I go for an Aqua Jet, and he's going to actually taunt me, which is awful. I thought he was going to go for... I don't know. It probably went better. He goes for Hurricane. He misses. I go for a Player Up. I thought he was going to switch out into Roserade. I just wanted to get as much damage off as possible on Roserade. It stays in. Now, he goes into Empoleon for some weird reason. He didn't go get an Agility. I thought I was going to switch, hoping I didn't have Superpower. But I do have Superpower. And now we're down to 2-on-2. We can make another comeback in straight consecutive days. Another comeback would be dope. It really would. So, he goes into Roserade, and I decide, you know what? I just need to have my Landers around. So, I got to do what I can. And, to keep Landorus alive, so Azumarill dies, it's 1-2, we still have Landorus-Therian, and I go, and I know I can do a solid amount with Earthquake. Now, I did a calc, if he's a standard set, I won at KO 100% of the time with Earthquake, but he told me he's not a standard set, but I'm hoping that means he took it out of special attack. If we took it out of a special attack to put in HP, then I can live a, if I don't kill him, I can definitely live a Leaf Storm if he took it out of special attack, which I'm hoping he did. I go for the Earthquake. We're going to find out right now if he was truthin' or lying. He was truthin'. He was being truthful. But that means I can live the Leaf Storm. Live at 39 HP. Going to go ahead and Earthquake and take him out. And that will be the game. So I hope you guys enjoy this. Make sure you subscribe to myself and Gubstacular. Link in the description. Rate, comment, sub. And I will see you guys next time. Peace.